Back in? All right. The board's back in public session while in executive session. No actions were taken. In the review of the case presented, we have had discussion about the what appears to be a structure at the end of the dock, which it does not appear to have been a part of the original permit. A neighbor has expressed concern about that. I feel like that. Also looking at the navigation impact and the staff's use of the Army Corps model. Are there Army Corps of Engineers maintain navigational projects, coastal engineering manual in the design and approving of that navigation. Are there any other concerns that you have regarding the permit, the navigation? And do you feel like staff has appropriately looked at the regulations, applied them to this permitting so that we should or should not go forward with a RFR?
Yes, I can make a motion. Yeah, I move to deny a final review conference on docket number 19-RFR-23.
Okay, we have a motion. Is there a second? I have a motion and a second. All right. Is there any further discussion? All right. Seeing none, I'll have a vote. All those in favor of the motion signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Okay. Very good. So we have that first docket item done.
Thank you.
Thanks. Say hello to Sam.
All right. The second item on our docket for today is RFR 19 RFR 25, Bo Hickett Investors LLC, issuance of a critical area permit number 1982-0766118. And that's item 2 in our booklet, in which the Bo Hickett Investors has requested a permit and has been permitted and is being challenged regarding dock situation. There was also some issues raised regarding erosion control and riprap under existing boardwalk. Are there any questions that y'all have in having looked at the material? They did submit an engineer's materials, engineering report, doing some of that, but it seems to have. Looking at this, I almost see two issues. There's a soil erosion control in the dock, and the permit is for the dock at the Bo Hickett Marina. Anything you could add, Marshall, you want to add in?
I think you have described it well. The primary concern, while there are other concerns raised, at least the initial concern is by the requester, is that the permittee is not in compliance with their current permit, and therefore they should not be allowed to do additional work until that compliance is resolved. That's what the request appears to say.
So the erosion issues that are shown in the picture, they are not a compliance issue with the current permit.
So what the staff response says is that they went out a couple of times to inspect, and that they did not find the existing structure out of compliance. They mentioned that there was some erosion, but the response indicated that that appeared to be from landward. It was landward erosion as opposed to from coastal impact.
And landward erosion would not be a permanent.
That'd be runoff this way as opposed to this way. Though if it impacted the structure, it wouldn't matter, right? Okay. If the structure was not maintained for whatever reason, that would be a non-compliance issue. But, anyway, they indicated that it appeared to be in compliance.
And then these pictures that are in Exhibit 2, are they staff pictures or are they someone else's pictures?
Let's see. So staff's response starts, okay, you're talking about pictures 1 through 61, 61 pictures, the little pictures?
No, these big pictures in Exhibit 2.
So that appears to be DHEC's pictures. These big pictures? It says DHEC at the bottom.
No, see?
I think those may be part of the requesters.
Page numbers. Okay, yeah, I'm sorry. Okay, yeah, Exhibit 2. So Exhibit 2 is part of, I think, the requesters.
Yeah.
Right. He's got two exhibits.
Two?
The requester. Actually, he's got three exhibits.
Yeah,
three exhibits. Or four exhibits. He's got four exhibits. So you're referring to Exhibit 2?
Yes.
Okay, so requester talks about Exhibit 2. He says subsidence was the direct result of the absence of any bulkhead and sloughing riprap. So that represents, he says it is of import that this timber bulkhead was recently installed by permittee under a separate permit in order to address significant erosion problems in this area. In fact, portions of the commercial patio and fountain area also owned by permittee were falling into the water due to subsidence of high ground. The subsidence was the direct result of the absence of any bulkhead and sloughing riprap. So that's what that's supposed to show.
Yes, the problem with this is there's no date associated with it. So I guess when staff went out there, this condition may not have existed.
To the extent that this was relevant to the current permit, and staff is saying that it's in compliance.
And
that
it's in compliance.
Right, okay. They said there was a small, like 1% area that was missing, 1% of the total bulkhead.
Okay.
That might be that part where it's missing there.
Okay.
And there's some with the next exhibit, or the two exhibits, the engineer's report, that don't seem to be quite as sensational. They do show some areas where the riprap and there's some erosion, but it does not seem to be as emotional as some of the others.
This is Exhibit 4.
Yeah, on the little pictures. That was part of their engineer's report. Which does address some issues that the property owner needs to deal with. But it does not necessarily impact the dock permit that's up.
It's in the shows a section of riprap that's washed away, Title 28.
Any comments, any thoughts?
I guess as far as I'm concerned, I feel better about it now. I would defer to the staff decision, to allow the permit to go forward.
Yeah. You have any thoughts, Mr. Chairman?
I agree.
All right, so I have a motion to deny a final review conference on docket number 19 RFR-25.
Except for Mr. Singleton.
Yes, I'll make a motion to deny a final review conference on docket number 19-RFR-25.
Yeah, I have a second. All right, any discussion? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? None. All right, very good. With no further items on our agenda, we're dismissed.